If the desert is holy, it is because it is a forgotten place that allows us to remember the sacred. Perhaps that is why every pilgrimage to the desert is a pilgrimage to the self. There is no place to hide, and so we are found. The wind rolls over me, particles of sand skitter across my skin. Particles of sand skitter across my skin, fill my ears and nose. I am aware only of breathing. I am aware only of breathing. The workings of my lungs are amplified. I am aware only of breathing. I am aware only of breathing. The wind picks up. I hold my breath. It massages me. The wind picks up. I hold my breath. It massages me. The wind picks up. I hold my breath. It massages me. A raven lands inches away. I exhale. The raven flies. Things happen quickly in the desert. I believe in walking in a landscape of mirages. I believe in living in a land of little water. And I believe in the gathering of bones. I am desert. I am mountains. I am Great Salt Lake. I am desert. I am mountains. I am Great Salt Lake. I want to see the lake as woman, as myself, in her refusal to be tamed. I recognize her as a wilderness, raw and self-defined. I am desert. Salt Lake. I am desert. I am mountains. I am Great Salt Lake. Great Salt Lake is a spiritual magnet that will not let me go. This is why I always return. This is why I can always go home. Everything about Great Salt Lake is exaggerated. The heat, the cold, the salt, and the brine. It is a landscape so surreal, one can never know what it is for certain. Salt Lake. I am desert. I am mountains. I am Great Salt Lake. Great Salt Lake. Great Salt Lake.